Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out channelfireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Welcome to another vintage video. I've joined the dark side here. I'm playing with Mishra's Workshop in my deck. I decided to play a deck that looked pretty sweet. It has Lightning Greaves and Metalworker. So the combo here is to cast Greaves, equip it to Metalworker, tap Metalworker for millions of mana, play Kuldotha Forge Master, sack a bunch of artifacts, and get Blightsteel Colossus, which then gets the Lightning Greaves and attacks for lethal. It also has the normal Stax, you know, lockout element of Chalice, Thorn, Sphere, and Trinisphere. So, and plus Lodestone Golem, of course. And so this is what I'll be battling with. The sideboard has, you know, Mindbreak Traps against combo, especially if when you're on the draw. Dismembers against creature decks, like, it's good in the mirror, it's good against Delver. Sundering Titan against people with lots of lands. Steel Hellkite just to blow things up, like, it actually kills just about, you know, everything you care about, except, unfortunately, not Null Rod. Grafdigger's Cage against Oath, Ants, Dredge, Tormod's Crypt against just Dredge. And then Ghost Quarter for the mirror and Tabernacle for creature decks. So, actually in an 8-player event, because the daily event didn't fire, and let's get to it. Well, I think I will play first. Winning the die roll is pretty big in this particular matchup. In that matchup, I mean vintage. I will keep this hand. So this hand's very good. The question is, what do I do turn one here? You know, normally, so let's say I didn't have this Karn, right? I would play Chalice Zero Thorn, but because I have Karn, I actually think I'm okay to play Chalice for one here. So I'm going to play Chalice for one, then I'm going to play Thorn of Amethyst. So actually, I'll play the Thorn first. I'm going to go Mox, Thorn. And then if my opponent wants to go play a land and play some zero-drop artifacts, I can then go Karn, kill all your artifacts, because that's what Karn does. So let's play Thorn of Amethyst, forcing my opponent to either have Force of Will now or not be able to use it. Play Chalice, tap Chalice, and play it for one. Alright, and I have to remember not to F8, because if you F8, then tap Mishra's Workshop, it sometimes just auto-pass you if you don't have anything else you could do, though you have the Workshop mana floating. City of Brass into Go. Interesting. I hope that's not Dredge, because game one Dredge is pretty bad. Alright, let's play Karn, followed by Sphere of Resistance. I couldn't actually do it in the other order, unfortunately. Pretty good lockout here against most decks. Alright, my opponent, City of Brass, go. So I'm going to expect that to be a combo deck more than likely. And that game, that stacks on the play, by the way. So, that's what we're going for. So I'm going to put in the Mindbreak Traps. You have pretty much everything else you want against combo. Actually, I like Witchbane Orb. The reason I like Witchbane Orb is it stops Hercule's Recall, most importantly. It also could stop Tendrils, but your opponent's going to have ways to bounce things. I don't really want to... I guess I can put in Ghost Quarter, too, because those decks don't have any basics. Generally don't want duplicate. I'll keep duplicate in because of Tinker for Blightsteel. And then I'm going to take out a couple of the random creatures. You don't really need Worm Coils. I guess I'll keep a Steel Hellcat. The question is, do I keep Steel Hellcat or do I take out Crucible? I guess Crucible. I don't really need to do this multiple times. I'll leave in one Steel Hellcat just for value.